Hey y'all, welcome back to my channel. This is Adana, also known as the AfroZen. Today I'll be reading for the collective. Hey collective, how you doing? Happy Monday. Don't forget to like and subscribe, hit that notification bell. If this is your first time joining, welcome, welcome, welcome. If it's not, hey y'all, welcome back. All right. If you'd like to book a private reading with me or shop in my store, all the information is in my description box below. All right, so let's get into it. Hey, okay. What's going on with the collective? Somebody been going through a lot of stomach pain, stomach issues, okay? Might be having problems with moving your bowel. So some people might be constipated, okay? Prune juice. If you haven't tried that yet. Listen, we're just going to keep it being we all adults here. Someone is trying anal sex for the first time. Spirit, why I got no there for? All right, and that could be the reason. That could be the reason why you have issues next year. I heard yes. Okay, yeah. All right. Listen, rock out how you like. Right? No Oscar. I don't know my spirit. Sorry. Anywho. I'm hearing a strawberry sorbet is what I'm hearing as well. Okay, strawberry sorbet, peach sorbet. I'm hearing banana bread. Banana walnut bread. Dang, y'all make me hungry. I'm hearing corn soup. Okay, some of you guys might be West Indians listening to this. Hey. I'm hearing pigtails. Okay, just take how it resonates. I'm hearing Ecuador, Salvador, South America, New Jersey, Florida, Philly, Chicago. I'm hearing the numbers 3-8-58-313-888. All right, let's see. What else is going on? Okay. The story. So someone has a story here. Let me do this first. Collective. So like this. I'm also hearing ramen noodles, beef ramen noodles. I'm hearing ice cold coffee. I'm hearing postage lost. So you may have went to the post office and the postage was lost. So you had to repay it or repurchase it. Return the sender is what I'm hearing too. All right, so let's see. So what's going on with the collective? We're gonna do this story style. So okay, so someone is going through a transitioning moment from being in the connection to not being in the connection, then being in the connection again. So this is like a merry-go-round of a tirade of emotions, a lot of up and down, lots of years invested in this, okay? Now, with this card here, the soul and the change is here. So the soul... Soulmate change is in reverse. Someone is not willing to change for their soulmate or twin flame. Okay. Someone is not willing to change for their soulmate or twin flame. Okay. They're not willing to change. So there's a fantasy here that they don't want to be over. Okay, there's a fantasy here that doesn't want to be over, and they're in their feelings about this. okay? But if you look at this card here, the fantasy card, there are a lot of ants around this. It could be worker ants. Well, I'm assuming it is. These are worker ants. And someone is working very hard to make sure that this fantasy is still intact, okay? So this could be a sexual fantasy. Okay, now in regards to the story here, someone has had a pleasant experience or a pet. So this card down here represents souvenir. So someone may have had a pleasant experience about this scenario, about this story, about this connection. Okay, I'm gonna find out who is that. Where's my tipper? Who had a pleasant experience with this? Was having a pleasant experience. Okay, so a lover in marriage. Okay, lovers in marriage. Okay, so okay, so here's a masculine here. Masculine feminine connection that is here. The feminine energy looks like they want to move forward with their life path, their life journey. But the masculine energy here is still in love, okay? Because if you look at this card here, he has his hand wrapped really tight around her. So it looks like she's uncomfortable, but he's like kind of trying to keep her in close grip, so proximity, okay? The lover's card is here as well too. But if you look at the card, the male has more of a control over the female than the male do. It's not, it to me doesn't equate reciprocity, okay? Like if you look closely, just look, it's kind of like a, it's like he just have a control over her. If you look at the hand is just very strong but subtle. Hopefully you guys can understand what I'm trying to say. And even here, to me, look at the birds. The birds are not even close in proximity as well, too. Because if two birds are in love, when I see two birds in love, they're right next to each other. And there's a distance. There's a distance here, but with some sort of a control, if you can see right here, right? So with this lover card here, this feminine energy doesn't want anything to do with this masculine energy because the masculine energy refuses to change. The masculine energy refuses to change for their soulmate, okay? So because of that, they are in their emotions and they don't want this fantasy to end. Now, why don't they want this fantasy to end? Why don't they want this fantasy to end? They don't want this fantasy to end because they don't want to surrender it and they don't want to change it. It's just that simple. They want to have their cake and eat it too, and they don't want to take responsibility for their action in this part, okay? There's no peace here in regards to this connection because this masculine is going to make sure that there is any peace, but the feminine energy just want to move forward into abundance. Just want to move forward with abundance and be of service to others, okay? So maybe you're a nurse, a doctor, could be a teacher, anywhere that you may be positioned as someone helping or someone that's of service of others. Could be in the military as well too, okay? Feminine energy just wants freedom, all right? All right, but what causes infidelity? Okay, so the shadows caused this infidelity. And when I say shadows, basically meaning that this person is not healed. This masculine energy is not healed. So they're moving from relationship to next to next to next. And they're not taking the time in between those relationships to heal, to fully heal. Okay. Now this masculine energy may have some aspects of, they may have some healing aspect that needs to be healed from the mother and the father. And I say both mother and father because if you look here, this person looks androgynous. Both masculine and feminine energy is carried here. If you look at the hair, but this face to me looks masculine. We just gonna call it what it is. This looks like a male's face. But here looks like it could be from a woman's, you know, woman's hair, you know, woman's locks, woman's hair. So to me, it's giving me both worlds, both masculine and feminine. So this masculine energy was suffering or may had a lot of shadows surrounding their parents, okay? A lot of infidelity, a lot of cheating as well from their parents, okay? And that's what's causing this shadow. This is what's causing this shadow is learned behavior, okay? So this is what they grew up with. This is what they saw, growing up with their parents, okay? Or with their mom or their dad, take it how it resonates, okay? But it definitely comes from both sides of the family, all right? And they don't know, family is in reverse, and they don't know how to unplug from this infidelity because that's all they know. They feel like, or this masculine energy feels like you're supposed to have more than one person. And if that's the case, cool, rock out with your cock out, bruh. Rock out, but don't lead people down. Don't leave people with your bullshit. Like, give people the opportunity to make a decision for themselves. You don't make decisions for people on their behalf. No, that's not cool. Yeah, it's very sensual. So this is all about sex. And then the surrender card is in reverse. So you're not wanting to surrender. You're not ready to surrender your craves. And that's cool. But if you want to be single, be fucking single. That's it. Be fucking single. What else is going on with the collective? Create sacred space, clear and activate, okay? So feminine energy, it's time for you to take back your power and to clear and to activate your space. Get rid of things that no longer serves you, okay? If this person is not for your highest good, there's no reason for them to be around you, okay? Because people like them, this masculine energy, they're just, I don't want to say they, but this masculine energy is just there to just keep you down. And that's not fair to you, okay? Birth of creation, potential growth is in reverse. So yeah, they're doing everything possible to make sure that you're not growing in the way that you need to grow. You are that flower. You're that beautiful, pure flower. And when I say you're that flower, you need the water. You need the sunlight. You need all these things. But it feels like you're constantly always looking for someone to fulfill that for you. And you don't need anyone to fulfill that within yourself. You got to fulfill that within yourself. The same way it takes time for you to digest certain foods, especially if you're wanting to lose weight or you want to look a certain way, you have to eat certain foods. You have to do a certain regimen, right? You are responsible for what you digest within yourself, right? Well, why are you waiting for people to feed you love? You need to give yourself love. You need to feed yourself your love, the self-love that you so ever you're looking for and that you're yearning for. It starts with self, okay? Not two. One equals to self. You are self. It starts with you first. And as you begin to grow, it's going to multiply. Then you can have two, three, four, five. And I don't mean lovers. It can mean platonic friendships. It can be romantic relationships, connections, take it how it resonates. But everything starts with self. One, always remember that. Everything starts with one. Yes, so feminine energy, spirit is asking for you. Time for you. You are spiritually evolving. Set your heart free. Release the things no longer serves you and align your universe. Navigate distractions. Do not allow this masculine to distract you from their foolishness, for their tirades, for their childish tantrums, okay? Because I feel like when they don't get their way, they're always doing foolishness. They're always trying to keep you down. Don't allow the masculine to keep you down. Do not. They refuse to change and surrender. And it's clear as day because they said they're not going to do it. They say they're not going to do it. All right. Yes, listen up, feminine energy. Listen up and protect yourself. So if you're still having intimacy with this person, please protect yourself because they are out there heavily. This masculine energy is definitely heavily, heavily out there. And you don't want to get yourself any surprises. You don't want to get yourself any surprises. So make sure that you take care of yourself and protect yourself because this person doesn't care about you and damn sure don't care about themselves. Right? Yeah, they want to leave you feeling like you're powerless, like you don't have any power. All right? They don't want you to spread your good joy, your good cheer to anyone. They want to keep you in this desolate energy. They're always in your subconscious in a very negative way. You ain't shit. You ain't never going to be shit. That ain't going to work for you. This ain't going to work. Da-da-da-da. You know? They're in the dark right now. It's currently in the dark, but I feel like this is the future that they have for you is that they want to keep your future in the dark. They want to dim your light. Okay? They want to dim your light. They don't want to see you succeed. They don't want to see you get ahead. Purification and desire is in reverse. They're not willing to heal from this. Okay, they're not willing, the masculine energy is not willing they're not willing to throw away things no longer serves them. They have no desire to. They're literally showing you who they are, all right? But for you, feminine, okay, it's time for you to regenerate because right now you don't feel like you're taking the lead in your life and you need to take the lead in your life. But in order to get to the lead in your life, you have to regenerate. Meaning you have to let go of things no longer serves you, no longer serving you. And you know this because there's no hope in this connection anymore. You didn't agree to the things that this masculine has been putting you through. Okay? You were genuinely there for them. You genuinely love them, but they just didn't recognize that, right? And your positivity, you may have some days where you're positive, but it's not enough to make you successful or to feel successful. Right now, you don't feel successful. You have to move away from this masculine energy to get into the success energy. Happiness is in reverse in memory. Think about the great times and think about the bad times. Do the good outweigh the bad or do the bad outweigh the good? And if the good outweigh the bad, that's excellent. Absolutely, go for it. But if the bad outweigh the good, you know what you need to do. It's time for you to release this person with love and move forward. Close that chapter, block, delete, ignore them, and move forward in your healing process. You owe that to yourself. Okay, I'm also hearing kids are involved as well too, okay? You owe that to yourself and your children to move forward and to heal yourself. You don't deserve this, okay? You may not have the wisdom and you may not have the courage right now because you may not know which way to go, okay? You were just taught all your life that you had to sit in a situation or a connection where you're going to go through all different types of hell. That's not true and that's not love. That's old time behavior. And we don't move like that now. Okay, if you're not able to match my vibe, you're not able to match my drive or shit, if you're not even able to come in and assist me with my evolution as I am able to assist you with your evolution, then we don't need to be together. We don't need to have any discussion because the name of the game is to coming together with like-minded individuals, platonic, friendship, romantic, however, and it's to help each other evolve in many different ways, okay? It's all about your perception. But with this here, you don't have the courage and you don't have the wisdom you don't have the correct wisdom because growing up with family, mom and dad, grandmother, and so they went through all these things, the abuse, the lying, they didn't have bank accounts, they had to always depend on someone and something for some things, and you're still following that tradition, but you're coming up to a time or a space where you no longer want to follow. You don't want to carry that baton into the next cycle of your generation. So you are the generational breaker right now, and you're going through a lot. But I need for you to understand that this is not an easy journey. It's not an easy path, and I can relate. It ain't easy at all. But the first thing that you can do is to muster up the courage and tell yourself, acknowledge that you know that this situation is not helping you in the best way that you know that it can help you. Okay, you want to use that negativity and you want to fuel that. You want to transmute that into something great, into something positive. That's what's going to get you out of this situation. You and your power, your raw power that sits within yourself that you have yet to ignite. That is what's going to get you out of here. You're going to be that rocket that's flying up in the air straight all the way up. And like I said before, if a rocket blasts off, no one can be around to block it that blasts off, because if anyone or anything's around it, it will disintegrate or incinerate. So with that, collective, take back your power, take back your love, okay? And stop waiting for other people to give you love. You can give yourself love. You can give yourself love, okay? Yeah, because if you continue to stay with this person, it's going to be a negative continuous of no tranquility or no peace. This person is just here to wreak havoc in your life, okay? They're just here to wreak havoc. All right. Yeah, they're wreaking havoc. They're causing a disruption, and they are determined. They are determined to cause a disruption in your life. You don't deserve that. Don't trust them. Do not trust them. You do not deserve this behavior that they keep showing to you. They're making a fool of yourself, and you're making a fool of yourself. Learn to let go. And that's going to be the name of it. Learn to let go. All right. So that's all I have for the collective today. Oh, no. Wait. I keep forgetting this. I got to keep remembering this. I'm going to do this dice thing. All right. So we're going to see what energies are here or what signs are here. All right, we have Cancer, or Pisces. I'm sorry, Pisces. Ooh, no way, is that Cancer? I think that's Cancer. Then we have Taurus. I gotta get the symbols down pat. Y'all bear with me for that. And Scorpio. All right, let's do one more. Taurus again. All right, so those were the signs. If it resonates with you, let me know. Like, share, subscribe, hit that notification bell. Leave some comments below as well, too. I like to interact. Until next time, collective, peace.